Welcome to the Flute 360 podcast, where we incorporate a panoramic view of flute-related topics. I am your host, Heidi K. Begay, and this is episode 69, Lessons from Romania. Today's sponsor is brought to you by J&K Productions. Did you know that not only are they a production company for podcasts, but they are a recording company for musicians? Any musical recording needs that you may have, J&K Productions can fulfill that need. They have all the necessary equipment and expertise to record your next flute recording for college or graduate auditions, competitions, summer festivals, or a flute album. J&K Productions can record any setup imaginable, from solo flute, small chamber, flute and piano, and much more. Consider J&K Productions for your next recording project. Contact them at jkproductions.media. Hi everyone, welcome to another Flute 360 podcast episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. First and foremost, before we get to today's content, could you please go to your favorite podcast platform and rate, review, and subscribe? Thank you so much. The other thing that I ask you to do is to get your Flute 360 updates on a weekly, daily basis. Could you please follow me on Instagram, Tumblr, Twitter, Facebook, or LinkedIn? That would be great. Thank you so much. All right, y'all. So I'm going to get really real here. And that is, this competition has given me a complete 180 where I'm looking at my career and what I'm doing in a whole new light. So before I get into the nitty-gritty of the different insights and lessons that I've learned that I want to share with you all, let me give you my biggest takeaway. So that way I do not lose focus. And that is, please step outside of your comfort zone, whatever it is. And this is going to be defined in different ways for different people, because we're all unique individuals. So you know what your comfort zone is, but step outside of it, find a little bit of courage to do that for yourself, and find a small mustard seed of faith to be able to have that courage and to push forward in your career or your personal goals, whatever it is. Please do that for yourself. You will be so glad you did. Okay, so if you have not been following me on my preparation for the Cluj International Competition, please go back a few series and check that out, because having that information and that backstory will really prep you well for today's episode. All right, so you all know that I have been preparing these last 2 months for the Cluj International Flute Competition in Cluj-Napoca, Romania, in July of 2019. There were some really great small victories won, and there were some not so great victories won, and that's okay. So I fly into Romania, and I have a few days to adjust to the new time zone, right? Well, as I'm going there, I had these thoughts of, who do you think you are? Who do you think you are for going onto this international stage and performing, Heidi K. Begay? You're nobody. And so just know that if you are stepping outside of your comfort zone, the imposter syndrome is a real thing. So the few days leading up to my Monday performance were quite stressful and very emotionally draining. Find people in your life to ground you. For me, having my husband to talk to was great. Having my sister, Catherine, to talk to was very beneficial. Some friends like Nicola and Denisa and Lisa, I thank you all so much for your warm support and love. Also, meditating, praying to God helped me a lot. So just know that you're going to go through a whirlwind of emotions and thoughts, and that's okay. I think that's a part of the process. So I performed Monday, and there were some great things that I did musically. I really liked my Debussy, and I liked movements of the Hindemith. but I wasn't quite proud of some of the tempos I chose in the Telemann. It was a little too slow. The finale of Hindemith I thought was too slow too. But I had to take a step back and see, well, why did I not like that performance? What was the root of it? Because I knew that I had prepared well. And I looked at it and I looked at the situation for what it was. And I realized that my performance anxiety is deeply rooted into my psyche more so than I thought. So instead of getting mad at yourself and saying, why didn't you do this? Why didn't you do that? Look at it as a diagnosis and trying to diagnose the illness. You don't get mad at a cancer patient for having cancer. You say, okay, let's treat it, right? Same thing here. So I diagnosed and found that my performance anxiety is a real thing. Okay, so write yourself a prescription, get some help, and then try to find a cure. So for me, my work in progress, the takeaway that I took from my performance includes is I am going to put my foot down and say no more performance anxiety. I need to find a better way to approach it rather than it taking over. Okay, so for me, part of my prescription for this disease is reading more mental strength books like Brave New Athlete by Dr. Marshall, books like The Inner Game of Tennis. And quite frankly, it might have to mean me talking with a trained therapist. So that's where I'm at right now. That aspect did not go well for me, but I'm moving forward. The small victories that I had to pull from that performance is I really liked my preparation with the weeks and months leading up to the competition. I would definitely do that again. I was very intentional with my time. I was very disciplined with my time. And I looked holistically at the whole process. So I was taking care of my mind, my body, and my flute playing. I would do that again. The other thing that I would do again is the recital. I think that was great preparation for the competition. Okay, so moving forward, I had to look at the big picture because you can get so wrapped up in, I don't know, all of these things that could have gone better, didn't go well. Look at it from the big picture, bird's eye view. And I had to take a step back even further and say, well, why did I compete in the first place? And that was because I wanted to pursue a tenure track flute position. I thought competing under pressure could really help with my training with faculty recitals and recordings for my job application. So going back to the why I competed really helped ground me. And I encourage you to do the same thing if you lose sight of where you're at. For me, I have decided to stay the course. So here I'm deciding or rethinking my whole career path, which is crazy. But I think it's good to reflect. And it's like, do I continue this flute tenure track job search? Do I stop altogether? Do I go into administration? Do I teach junior high and high school flute students for the rest of my life? I really was reflecting on not just the competition, but my whole career path and not the competition itself. So that was really interesting. I was not expecting that. But for me, because I'm a Christian, I am sticking to God's will for my life. And that helps me make decisions in my world. And I can only give you my perspective because it's mine. I feel really strongly that God has placed on my heart the term education, and specifically education at the collegiate level. I'm going to still stay on course until God literally pulls the flute out from my hands. But with that, it's given me a time to reflect and how to navigate to pursue this goal of mine, because it's quite competitive out there. I encourage you, find out God's will for your life. Pray about it. Meditate on the Bible. Talk to Christian mentors. For me, that's the only way I make decisions in my life. So if you have stepped outside of your comfort zone and it did not go the way you anticipated for it to go, that's okay. You might have to take a few steps back and look at it from a bird's eye view to ground yourself and get some new insight. So hopefully by me just being vulnerable and sharing with you my thoughts and feelings with the days leading up to the competition and the days after the competition. Hopefully that will give you some encouragement for whatever goal you are setting out for next in your career. So whether it's a recital, an audition, a competition, a job application, hopefully some of those insights can help you and encourage you. To wrap up today's episode, I encourage you to pull out the small victories and also to step outside of your comfort zone. You will be so glad that you did. Before I leave you, I wanted to let you know that episode 70 comes out next Saturday, and that's also some insights and lessons from the Cluj International Flute Competition, but with clarinetist Aileen and flutist Martin Godoy. So check that out. I can't wait for you to hear their insights, and hopefully there are some really great gold nuggets that you can take away and apply to your next event. The last thing I want to leave you with is Flute 360's schedule. We are booked all the way through the end of October. We have this series, Lessons from Romania. I get to go to the National Flute Association and be at the William S. Haynes' flute booth. Come and see me there in Salt Lake City, Utah. And after that, I have a series with the one and only Robert Dick. We are going to talk about extended techniques and how to apply that to practicing and traditional repertoire. And I get to do a whole series with Powell. I am so excited. We are going to talk about flute repair, flute making, and I get to interview some Powell artists. So check that out. That gets us all the way to the end of October. I don't want you to miss out on such great content. For fun, I wanted to give you some picks. So my pick for today is 7th Generation's Laundry Detergent Travel Size. It has been such a great tool for traveling through Romania and Hungary. So this way I can hand wash clothes on the road, air dry it, and I don't have to worry about reading washing machines or dryers in different languages. And Eric's pick is mushroom soup from Hungary. Thank you for listening to today's episode, and until next time. Today's sponsor is brought to you by J&K Productions. Did you know that not only are they a production company for podcasts, but they are a recording company for musicians? Any musical recording needs that you may have, J&K Productions can fulfill that need. They have all the necessary equipment and expertise to record your next flute recording for college or graduate auditions, competitions, summer festivals, or a flute album. J&K Productions can record any setup imaginable, from solo flute, small chamber, flute and piano, and much more. Consider J&K Productions for your next recording project. Contact them at jkproductions.media. Thank you for listening to the Flute 360 podcast. For more information, please visit HeidiKBegay.com. And if you enjoyed today's episode, please rate and review in the iTunes store. Let's talk about flute.